and ring the bell. But yeah, no answer.
Hi there.
Good morning, sir.
Thanks,
Mike.
Glad you're here.
I would normally give you my card, but I left living at home.
No worries, no worries.
We don't normally go out on a Sunday morning, but I want to get you in before the holidays.
I really appreciate you.
My pleasure.
Means a lot. All right, so.
Tell me what's going on.
So we have three zones.
Okay.
First floor zone. The compressor outside runs.
Okay.
But it doesn't go on, and the air is not coming out. So just turn it on. So we'll see what happens. Let me just turn this down.
Gotta love these smart thermostats.
Right. Connects into my control for
Home automation, I know.
Yeah, you got it. You're seeing it all. Alright.
There's the click.
So, click, click.
Just double check this. Alright. We got blow motor. Not running. Make our way to the air handler. Okay. ICP. Pan is nice and dry. I have the switch off. Let's see what's going on in here. ECM motor. A little bit of nasty stuff growing in here, but no control board, just speed tappings and voltage. Fuse looks good. Let's see. 3/4 horse, 230. RPMs. That sucks. Took the ground wire out of that connection, put that screw back in, took that screw out, disconnected the low voltage, the white and the blue, and then the line voltage harness from that connector. Let's slide this down and out. Yeah, it sucks. You know that module is bad. And they're gonna get a new blow motor today. It sucks. Well, at least it's not a brand new motor. This is manufactured in June 24 of 2015. Nice clean blow wheel though. Except a lot of cocky in there though. We should get the spraying on and clean all that up. All right. Yeah, we should be able to get that out. Ooh, yeah, look at that, folks. Let's just check voltage with our voltmeter here and make sure we have what we're supposed to have. Test the black and yellow. 244 volts. So we know that's good there. Between common, the brown wire, and the blue, I'm getting 24 volts. I don't want to keep turning on and off the condenser. I don't feel like disconnecting anything. So we definitely have a bad module in this ECM motor. 240. 3/4 horse. Let's see what we got in the truck.
The truck. Just want to make sure I get the motor out, because if I need to bring the puller and the associated tools to operate the puller, I don't want to go down there twice. So the motor's out. It's a 1050 RPM, 208, 230, 3/4 horse. It's going to be an expensive Sunday morning for this whole motor.
All right, I got this rescue motor. Perfect. 3/4 horse, 1075, 115 or 208, 230. Perfect. Whew. Let's take that mounting bracket off that condenser fan motor, that blower motor, put it on this one and get them up and running. Now I know it's 58 degrees outside, but with the holidays approaching and unseasonably warm weather expected, you know, it's best that we're getting this done today for them. Tomorrow we do have an installation. Mount with motor plugs down. This is 115 jumper. Okay, so I could do 115 or 220, which is nice. The 230 volt is in there already. There's that beautiful motor. Nice. Any other instructions to hear? Yeah, read this first. Read enclosed motor installation and maintenance pamphlet. Read entire nameplate carefully. Heed all warnings. Okay, do not use it for nuclear, medical, life support related applications. Okay, so common is there, line, ground, neutral, and then the 24 volt taps for speed, 1 through 5 in the bottom. Okay, let's show on the road. Take this thing all the way off to get this piece of it. I think I'll go in there now. Yes. 1, 2. So tighten this up a little bit. Okay. Let's make sure that the band is on level. Okay, I think we're good. All right, let me tighten this up. Bands are on. Let's get this thing slid into the blower wheel.
All right. The motor bracket mounts are secured. When I took off the old blower wheel, I put a little silicone grease on the housing, inside of the housing. And that's that liquid you see right there. I just use, here it is. Right. Just some silicone grease that plumbers use on plumbing stuff, but it also helps me slide this thing right back in. All right, we got to put the set screw in and set the motor. All right, I'm not forgetting about the cocky growing inside this thing. So I'm spraying it all down with spray nine. Let that soak in, and I'm going to wipe it down. Wet rag. Alright. Yeah, it's pretty nasty. Oh, man. Let's put this over the motor. Let's do another pass of spraying on. All right. We're good to go. To the races, folks. All right, unit is up and running. Got my sticker on there. This QR code brings you right to our landing page at pipedoc.net to book a service call directly in our CRM. We use House Call Pro for scheduling, dispatching, invoicing, and payment receiving. If you're a tradesman still using paper and pen, check out housecall.com/Mikey Pipes, link in the description box down below, and start running your business in the 21st century instead of the 19th century. I got a picture of the rating plate, which identifies the model, serial number, and specifications of this ICP air handler. Ductwork overall looks okay. Another satisfied client. Let's go. Check the outdoor unit. Make sure nothing's out of the ordinary with it. I'm not here for it, but I'm just gonna check it. Okay.
Not terrible. We can use a cleaning. What's up with that there?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is 9:21. According to House Call Pro, I spent 58 minutes on site, and I believe I did an exceptional job. Could I have done more? Could I have cleaned the outdoor condensing unit? Yes. But on a Sunday as an emergency? No. But I did take care of what I could easily take care of, which was clean all that organic growth inside the air handler on the insulation panels. And you know what? When the end user, the consumer, the homeowner feels and realizes the perception of value and that you went above and beyond, even though this bill was well over $1,000 to put in an ECM motor, I still got a gratuity. And that is the second best compliment you can receive when you do service work. The best gift they can give you is the gift of referring you to another potential client. And that's awesome. What's even better here is that, you know, everything, it comes full 360. So this gentleman, this family, was referred to by a local plumbing and heating contractor that I do some work with now and then. And I refer him work, he refers me work. And one hand washes the other. But, you know, when he heard that this gentleman's air conditioning wasn't working, you need to call Pipe Doctor at 516-348-6300. Look at that, folks. Got the job done Sunday morning, 9:22, and just enough time for me to pick up my in-laws at the airport. Bow! I'll catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.